If you enjoy this video, please remember to hit that like, subscribe, and share button. Seriously, it takes like 0.17 seconds. Hello everybody and welcome to another Shadow Pyro video. And this is a special video because in this video I'm going to be showing you not one, but two great exploits that are going to help you in your Destiny quest. The first one is going to be this one. This is an unlimited glimmer exploit. Sorry. A little hard to say. But the mission you want to do is you want to go over here and you want to select the moon. You want to go to this top right corner and select the Shrine of Oryx. Alright, the Shrine of Oryx is where we're going to do this. Make sure that you change it to level 12 before you launch this. You have to be a level 12 to get this to work the way that you want it to. And basically what you're going to do is you're going to get it to level 12, click launch, go on about your business and all that good stuff. Whenever you start the mission, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and play through it. You can take the time and kill the people if you want. But what I do is I haul ass through it, try to get through it as quickly as possible. And you want to play until you get to the spot where it says no respawns allowed. Alright, that's the spot that you want to get to. And that's where we're going to cut into. Because actually, once you get there, because we're not actually going to beat the mission. We're going to be in one specific area, we're going to die, then we're going to go back to that area, then we're going to die, then we're going to go back to that area, and so on and so forth. And as long as you don't complete the mission, when you start the mission, like I just did right here, it'll put you right at that no respawn spot. So it's great, it's fantastic, it makes everything easier, so let's do it. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and jump in here, and I apologize. Oh, excuse me. I apologize if it's a little laggy. I've been having some issues with my capture card. But anyway, all you're going to do is you're going to run up these stairs, and you're going to kill these guys. If they don't have a yellow bar over their head, don't even worry about it, guys. Don't even bother with it. But you can see over there on the right, our glimmer is just shooting right up. Just keeps on climbing. Alright, what I like to do is I like to go up here and I like to, you know, try to get as many of them as I can. But, you know, they tend to scatter. They take off and then they go down here. So you just kind of hang out up here. And I wouldn't recommend going down there on the ground until you've killed them all. And every time you do this, there should be between 6 and 8 of these guys that you can kill that have the yellow bar on their head. And as long as you have fairly decent armor and a fairly decent gun, they are really easy to kill and you are really hard to kill. Alright, so it's just like a perfect confection of awesome. And, you know, not only are you getting glimmer, but you're also getting a couple other things, you know, a couple other little cool things. Like the Silken Codex, which you can take to the Cryptarch and he will buy them from you. I did this for about 20 minutes and I had 11 of those things, okay, which I then took to him, sold for 200 bucks a pop, 2200 glimmer in my pocket for doing virtually nothing. Alright, so after you kill those guys, you gather up all your loot, just run over here, jump off this cliff. It's going to do a little countdown, it's going to give you a screen just like this one right here that says you had this many kills and you died this one time. Blah, 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 blah. Boom, spawns you back in. Lather, rinse, repeat. You can literally do this as many times as your little heart desires. It will just keep going and going and going and going. And one of the other things that you can get, and I cannot for the life of me remember the name of it off the top of my head, but it's something like Black Wa- or Idol of Wax. Idol of Wax or something like that. But anyway, you get those by killing these guys with the yellow bars over their heads. You pick those up, and if you go to your inventory and use one of those, double glimmer, son. That's right, for about 10 minutes, double glimmer. And the cool thing about it is when you use one, it lasts about 10 minutes. So you'll go through one little section here, die, come back, and as long as you do it quick enough, you can get 2 or 3 runs out of that one Idol of Wax. So it's pretty freaking sweet, guys. And like I said, check around, you know, make sure all the guys are dead before you go jumping off of there, because if they get up on you, they will ruin your day. But anyway, guys, that's this one. So the next thing we're going to take a look at is how to get an item farm. That's right. Legendary armor, rare armor, everything that you can ask for. Let's do it. Alright, guys, so here we go with part 2. And what you want to do is you want to go to Venus, and you want to go to the patrol missions. You're going to spawn in right there where I just started. You want to jump on your Sparrow, and you want to go down this trail and go exactly where I go. Now, I'm going to go a little bit, and then I'm going to stop, and go a little bit, and then I'm going to stop. That way, you guys can catch up. And also, while you're watching this, I want you to take note of which areas have enemies, because they can kill you, and then it's going to throw everything off. But anyway, guys, while we're getting over there to the area, I'm going to explain to you how this little exploit works, okay? Basically, the rundown of it is you're going to be put in an area where, on one side, goblins constantly spawn, and on the other side, dregs constantly spawn, and they're fighting in the middle, okay? The entire time you're going to be over there, there's going to be enemies. They keep coming and coming and coming. It is ridiculous. But basically, all you're going to do is you're going to kill them. All right? It doesn't matter how you kill them. Doesn't matter what you kill them with. I use my auto rifle. I use my fusion rifle. And I use my machine gun. And I use my super and my grenade. I use everything to kill these guys. And the results are always the same. For this one, it's important to remember, you're not doing this to get RP, and you're not doing this to get Glimmer. You're doing this to get the drops from the people that you kill. So it doesn't matter if you shoot them in the head, if you shoot them in the stomach, whatever. Shooting them in the head, it's obviously much more effective with the dregs. With the goblins, they have a little crystal in their stomach. If you shoot that crystal, they'll explode. And a lot of times, it's a one-hit kill. So that's something to keep in mind if you get into a bind. Your super will charge up pretty quick because you're constantly killing people. Use it, guys. If you see a big group of them, just run in there, throw your fist down if you're a titan, or pull out your little gun if you're a hunter or whatever, you know, and just go to town, man. Do work. Now, I do want to say that what we're doing here is not foolproof, okay? You can do this for 30 minutes and not find a piece of legendary armor or a legendary weapon. All right, that is a possibility, guys. I will say this. I did it for 45 minutes, and in that 45 minutes span, I came out of there with about 15 pieces of green, which is the uncommon armor and weapons, which I just scrapped and threw away because I'm a level 21 and I have no use for that shit. Came out of there with about 15 pieces of green, about 4 or 5 pieces of blue, and one legendary heavy weapon, Ingram. Now, with the blue, the rare Ingrams, there is a possibility still that if you get those and you collect them, when you take them to the Crypt Arc, there is still a chance that he will turn that into something legendary. So if that's all you get is a bunch of the blue ones, don't get all pissy and, oh, well, I'm not playing this anymore. Shadow Pyro lied to me. Meh. All right, don't do that, because there is still a chance that you can get something legendary out of it. Now, like I said, guys, this little system is not foolproof, okay? This is grinding, is what it is. You gotta put in the time, you gotta put in the effort, and, you know, just have faith. You know, it's all luck. There's a video of a guy here on YouTube that does this, and the entire ground is just filled with items. But, I mean, he probably put in a good 2-3 hours. All right? He was doing some serious work, guys. Excuse me. But another thing to remember is you are playing in a multiplayer environment, so anybody else can just randomly show up. So pay attention to what you kill and, you know, take note of it, because somebody else could show up, pay attention to what they're doing, make sure they don't steal your shit. Also, this little area right here, there is a mission that takes place in this area. So if some people come through and they're on that mission, then you're going to have a shitstorm coming your way, all right? Because it's going to be like 4 or 5 mini-bosses, you know, like the captains and the knights, that type of thing. They got the armor, they got the yellow health, all that shit, and you're going to have to deal with it because you're in the area and that's what they're doing. So you're gonna kind of be stuck in that. It happened to me while I was playing earlier. But anyway, guys, all you got to do is over there where you're looking right now in that direction, that's where the goblins spawn, and then directly on the other side of the map is where the dregs spawn. Me personally, I had better luck taking out the goblins. The dregs spawn right over here. You can see that we have an item there and an item there. So, I mean, this, like I said, guys, this is time consuming. It does take work. You know, it does require you to actually do something. You know, unlike the money glitch or the glimmer glitch that you just watched at the beginning of this video, you know, this is, it's a crapshoot. It's not guaranteed. The glimmer exploit, that's guaranteed every time. Excuse me. That's guaranteed every time. You're going to have the same result every time you do it. Keep an eye out for those little flower things, too, while you're doing this. They will constantly spawn along this wall, so you can be building on that, too. Whatever gun is your favorite gun, that is the gun that you need to use on this, because you will be working towards the upgrades for that gun. I upgraded my rifle probably 7 times while I was doing this. But you can see here, we just picked up a rare drop. And, you know, we're just cruising right along. You know, we're just cruising right along. And that's 3 drops, and we haven't even been over here, what, 1.5 minutes, 2 minutes? So, I mean, this system, guys, it works. It does work. You have to have faith, okay? And I'm not going to let this video run too long. I mean, I just want to give you guys an example of how it works. I've got roughly, you know, 40 minutes left of this gameplay that I'm not going to put everything into it, but I will go ahead and show you guys when I go to claim all the stuff that I got. So we're going to go ahead and cut to that. So there you have it, guys. We ended up picking up 6 items, 5 of which are rare, and you can see the one purple there. That's a heavy weapon that is legendary. Hopefully you liked this video, guys. If you did, make sure you click that like button. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and do that too, because more videos like this will be coming. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care.